welcome to Strasbourg, Mr. Titmuss. You're a guest of honor of the festival this year. And we would like to talk a bit about your career in the genre film. And especially in the slasher movies, because if we look back at your career, you made a lot of slasher movies, whether the killer is a lift or a lion or a saint. Did you find inspiration in the, some cult classic slasher movies?
Of course, when I started out, movies like Halloween and Jaws and Friday the 13th, you know, were prominent movies then, you know. It was the end of the 70s, beginning of the 80s. When I saw it, The Lift was my first movie, so when I came up with the idea, you know, it was based a little bit on the Stephen King story, The Mangler, and I modeled it, the movie, a little bit after the movie Jaws, you know, the build-up, you know, the pacing and everything. So sure, that's where my inspiration came from. I made, you forgot to maybe to mention Amsterdam, I don't know. You know, there's also a serial killer in the channels, in the canals. So I did a lot of, made a lot of serial killer stuff.
Exactly. And The Lift was your first movie, and it was a huge success, and not only in Holland, but worldwide. Mm-hmm. Do you think it was the right story at the right time?
Yeah, for Holland, it was in the first place, because there never were made horror movies till that time in Holland. So, and The Lift was, I wouldn't call it an all-out horror movie, but it was certainly, there were a lot of horror elements in it. And nobody believed in it, you know, when I made the movie, but it went on to be a huge success, because it was also very new in Holland, you know, that there finally was a movie like this made. And it was also the first movie that was sold worldwide to Warner Brothers, so it went all over the world, and it was, everybody related to it. It was a big success.
And the Warner Brothers, they wanted to remake it in English? Did they propose something like this to you?
Yeah, there was always talk in the 80s of remaking it, and not immediately. So the first thing they did, they brought it out, you know, and the Lift is obviously in the Dutch language, so they brought it out as a Dutch movie with subtitles. We did also a dubbing, an English dubbing. But they always liked the idea of making a sequel also out of it. But at that time, I didn't really fancy the idea, because, you know, I was busy with other movies, and I thought, well, yeah, I can make immediately a remake of my first movie, but let's make other movies first, and I did it first.
Of course. And in France especially, you are well known as a genre director for horror movies, but I think in Holland you are very popular for a comedy called, that's a series of comedy that's called Flodder.
Yeah.
And so we can see the way you use humor also in horror, that you are very at ease using humor in your films.
Because, you know, I like to do both. I've made comedies, I think four up to now, you know, three with the Flodder family, and I made a television series, a spin-off of the Flodder families. And I also did another other comedy just 10 years ago called Killer Babes, was also a comedy. But I like to do them both, you know. One time I do a horror movie, and then it's nice to do something lighter, a comedy. Yeah. And always the humor gets also in horror movies. I can't do a horror movie where you can't laugh at any moment, you know, so that always creeps in.
I can see that. And you were mentioning Killer Babes you made like 10 years ago, and you say it's a comedy. Yeah. For some, it's also a violent thriller. It's like it's both. It's a crossover movie.
Yeah. Okay. There are action parts in it, but mainly it is it's a comedy for me.
And well, let's talk about Prey, your new movie. It's again a serial killer movie, but well, with actual serial killer is a beast, is a lion. And at the beginning of the movie, I thought a lot about the building of a psychosis in the society.
What?
Building of paranoia.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, because yeah. Everyone is scared of something they don't see.
Yeah.
And it just reminded me of the actual situation of terrorism and the way our society lives with some kind of fear. I don't know if you feel the same.
Well, that was not really the idea to put that feeling in the movie, you know. Mm. Sometimes things are scarier when you don't see them, so I wanted to postpone the moment where the lion pops up of his, can be seen as much to the back as possible. So you, I think 30 or 40 minutes into the movie, you see for the first time the lion, and before that, it's only, you know, if you see too much immediately, the tension is gone, you know, the suspense is gone.
Exactly. And if I can ask you, what is the budget of Prey?
A secret.
It's a secret.
Very little. Well, to Dutch standards, it was a little more expensive than average. It was 3 million euros.
Okay.
A little more.
Yeah. Yeah. It's not that much to make a movie with a beast in the downtown Amsterdam.
No, it's for international standards, it's very little money.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. And can we speak about the way you did the lion? Did you use CGI all the time? Do you also use mechanical effects?
Yeah, I have to tell, but when we started out, you know, with the idea, we have to have a movie with a lion, and the lion has to interact with the actors, you know, there's our fights with the lion and so on. I started with the simple idea. I thought, well, I get a lion from England, I move it to Amsterdam and block some streets, and there I'm going to get my shots with the real lion. But when we checked it out, there was no way to get a lion to Amsterdam and to get permission for that. And also, shooting with a real lion is very difficult, you know, because they're, especially the male lions, are very lazy.
Okay.
So you can get the lion, run one time past camera, and then he wants to sleep all afternoon. The female lions are much more busy, you know, they are providing the food, they are hunting, they are the hunters. But I needed a male lion. So immediately it became clear that I couldn't use a real lion, so I had to rely on CGI. So that was another problem, because we didn't have much experience in Holland to make a CGI lion, to make a 3D lion on the computer. But we figured that out with a small crew, and a great part of the movie we have a 3D lion. Mm-hmm. And also because there are fights, and we needed a sort of animatronic, so we built an animatronic. First I looked around if there was worldwide, if you could find an animatronic. Because, you know, we had a few movies like Ghost in the Darkness, who used an animatronic, and all the other movies with lions. But they weren't that good, I think. So we built one ourselves, and I think we built one of the better animatronics lions, you know, a lion that could move everything in his face and so on. So eventually we have the 3D lion, we have the animatronic lion, and sometimes for fairly short cuts we have a man in a suit. So.
Okay, and just to ask you, you said you wanted a male lion, so it's just about the visual, about the bear.
Yeah.
You wanted to be
yeah.
male.
Yeah, it looks to me better than a female eye.
Of course. And you were talking just before about Joe's, that it was a big inspiration for you at the beginning of your career. And in Joe's, I think the shark appears like in the last third of the movie, in the last 30 minutes, before you see very few of the shark.
I'm not sure when the... I timed it one time when you see the first shark, and it is... I thought it was sooner. It was
okay.
A bit sooner because I think the first shot is when he isn't that where he comes up. You know when Brody is feeding, and then suddenly.
That's on the boat.
On the boat.
Yeah. And I think yeah.
Is it before there?
I'm not sure, but.
Okay.
Anyway, do you think it's still possible today to do a monster movie when you see the monster that late in the movie? Or you have to, because of the way audience looks at film today, you have to show it sooner?
No, I don't think so. If you can really build a suspense, you know, a good example is, of course, the first Alien movie. You know, you only see the alien at the end of the movie. You see brief shots, you know, when he attacks people, but you never know really how the monster looks like. And at the moment you see the monster, then a lot of suspense is gone, you know, so because it's so, when he flies out of the spaceship, you know, in Alien, it's a bit of a letdown. You think, well, was that the monster? So it's always good to show, but in my lion movie, it's, I was, on the one hand, I wanted to show the lion at a late point, but on the other hand, I thought, well, everybody knows what a lion looks like, you know. It's not like in Alien where nobody knows what it looks like, and that should be also a surprise. But a lion, everybody knows. So, and I really wanted to have the sequence where the delivery boy on the scooter, you know, is chased by the lion to the streets of Amsterdam. Well, you can't do a sequence like that without showing the lion, of course.
Of course, that's the first big sequence when you see the lion. And yes, and you were talking about suspense, and that reminds me of a conversation we had last night about It, the new movie adapted from Stephen King, and we both said that now you can see gory shots in every movie, and you said something very important to me. You said, let's bring back the suspense.
Yeah, that's I think what's lacking from the movie, you know. Gory elements that are the easy part, and nobody is scared anymore, you know, when you have a chopped off arm or leg or heads are flying. That's a sort of normal thing in movies nowadays, you know, and you don't get scared by that anymore. But you have, if you get scared when you build it really, you have a building in tension and in suspense. And that's very difficult to do, and you have to play with that, you know. And I think in my opinion, lacked that for the greater part. And it became a sort of repetitive. And when you know, when you expect things to happen, and yeah, they do happen, you know. Then every surprise is gone, and yeah.
Yeah.
And the suspense is also gone, I think.
And doing Prey, it's what you had in mind all the time, keeping the suspense.
No, not all the time, but I try to, in every scene, you know, with the lion, I try to build up suspense that you don't know when he's going to attack, where he is, what's going to happen. You have to, the public should be still be guessing, you know, what's going to happen, but also one of the more important things in a suspense movie is that your main characters have to have a plan, so that you as an audience can go with them, you know what their plan is, and then see if they succeed. And if you don't understand the plan, you know, people are just doing things and, well, suddenly there's an attack, yeah, that also kills the suspense. But if you are involved with the main characters and you know what they have to do and what their plan is, to kill the beast or to get out or whatever, you know, then then you can really get involved as an audience, and it can get really scary. And then that builds, that helps the suspense you feel.
Yeah. And in Prey, you have, I think, a kind of fascination for the beast, for the lion, more than for the people, because lots of characters, like the first hunter, they are like funny characters.
Yeah.
Yeah. We can see you're just looking for them to be killed.
Yeah. Especially the one you mentioned, the first hunter that they hire to get. That was a difficult part in the movie, because I didn't want it to be too funny, you know. That is, it's a sort of, how do you call it, a sort of opera guy, a guy dressed up, you know, like a hunter. I tried to not go over the top with that character, you know. That is not, we're all certainly in a different movie.
Exactly.
So that was a bit of, we had to be careful with that, you know, to tone it down.
So sometimes you're very conscious of the humor in the movie, not to let the humor top.
That's always the horror. Yeah, that's a difficult balance always. And I'm in other movies I made, sometimes the humor took over, and then the horror was gone, or was became unbelievable, or you know, and it's always difficult to have a good balance between the two. You know, that there are points in the movie that you have to laugh, and there are points that you have to get really scared. And if you spread out that nicely throughout the movie, you know, and have a balance in it, then it strengthens each other, you know, and that's always the problem, to get the balance right.
Prey is a very ambitious film. Lion attacks in downtown Amsterdam. So what do you want to do next? Come back to comedy, or do another genre movie, horror movie?
I'm not sure what I'm going to do next. I had a big action movie planned, but that is too expensive now, because it's becoming more and more difficult in Holland to finance the movies anymore. So that I can't get off the ground at the moment. So I'm looking for good material now to do, and if it is a suspense movie or horror or thriller or a comedy, I don't know yet.
Okay. So, thank you for the answers.
That's good. Thank you.